إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، my dear respected brothers in Islam, as we all know that we are fast approaching the blessed month of Ramadan, for which first and foremost we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He, Dhul Jalal Ikram, enables us to witness this season of reward and good deeds, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq and ability to make the best usage of the month of Ramadan. Secondly, my dear brothers in Islam, as we are fast approaching the month of Ramadan, we need to prepare ourselves for this very special occasion. As we make the preparation whenever we have an event in our life, if we were to arrange a wedding, we make a preparation. If you want to travel to another country, you spend a couple of days or even weeks or months to prepare yourself for that journey. And now we are very close to the month of Ramadan, an opportunity when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to close all the gates of hellfire, and all the doors of the mercy and the Jannah and paradise will be wide open. It will be an opportunity for us to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to seek forgiveness and to attain His mercy and His blessings. That is why it is very, very important for us to prepare ourselves. When we talk about the preparation for Ramadan, there are a number of things that we need to bear in mind. First and foremost, which is very, very important, is we must seek knowledge. We must learn about the fasting. We must know how to spend the month of Ramadan. We must know, and we must spare some time to go through the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to know the sunnah and the practice of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with regards to the month of Ramadan particularly. Seeking knowledge is one of the core obligations upon Muslim anyway, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, talabul ilmi faridatun ala kulli muslim. Seeking knowledge is an obligation upon every single Muslim. But there are certain matters within the religion of Islam that you need to know them in depth, and fasting is one of them. Because fasting, the month of Ramadan, is one of the pillars of Islam. Every single Muslim, every single one of us, we have an obligation to know about the fasting, the rulings on the fasting. And we must know the do's and don'ts, what is permissible and what is not permissible. How to begin the fast, how to end the fast. There are so many details that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given us, what can be done and what cannot be done while fasting, what breaks the fast and what does not break the fast, who has to fast and who are exempted from fasting, and those who are exempted, what is the situation and what is the ruling with regards to them, what are the different ways of making up the missed fast. Is there any other way to compensate for missing fast? So there are so many rulings that we need to learn. And we should not spend the month of Ramadan that the month of Ramadan goes and we go through and we pass by the month of Ramadan and we know nothing. And on every single day, we worry. Whenever we come across a situation, we try to contact an imam and the imam is not available, then we end up committing mistakes within the month of Ramadan and we lose the opportunity and we lose the reward. That is why it is very, very important that we must seek the knowledge about the fasting. Not only fasting, other things that we must be doing within the month of Ramadan. For example, many people decide to pay their zakah during the month of Ramadan. You must know the ruling, how to calculate your zakah, what type of the wealth you need to pay zakat on. Do you need to pay zakah on your salary? Do you need to pay zakah on your savings? What type of saving you need to pay zakat on? Is there zakah on property? Is there zakah on loan? There are so many rulings. We must know them. If you have decided to pay your zakah during the month of Ramadan, you must know the ruling as well. This is something that you cannot leave for an imam to answer your question every single time. Or you approach the imam only whenever you come across a difficult situation. No, you as a Muslim, you must know. These are the basics of Islam. This is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, طَلَبُ الْعِلْمِ فَرِيضَةٌ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ. And the scholars have said that it is compulsion and it is an obligation upon every single Muslim to know and to understand the basics of Islam so that he and she is able to worship Allah Dhul Jalali Wal Ikram. And as we know, the fasting and zakah, both of them, they are the pillars of Islam. Every Muslim must know about them. So this is one of the most important parts of our preparation for the month of Ramadan. And we must not forget it. Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, he, in his book, Sahih al-Bukhari, he set a chapter called Kitab al-Ilm. And under this chapter, he had many subheadings. And one of them, he said, Bab al-Ilmu qabla al-Qawli wal-Amal. Knowledge comes before saying and actions. You must have knowledge before you say anything or before you do anything. How can you practice the religion of Islam without knowledge? You must understand the rulings of whatever you want to do within the religion of Islam. And then Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, in order to support his claim and his statement, al-ilmu qabla al-qawli wal-amal, knowledge comes before saying and action, he, rahimahullah, took the evidence from the ayah of the Quran in Surah Muhammad, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ فَعْلَمْ. The word فَعْلَمْ comes from ilm, which is knowledge. You must know what? أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. There is none worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the word ilm, fa'alam, before la ilaha illallah, even before the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can a person enter into the fold of Islam without knowledge? If a non-Muslim wants to convert to Islam, we ask them, what do you know about Islam? What is your knowledge about Islam? And we do not advise a person who has no knowledge about Islam to accept Islam because he doesn't know. That is why knowledge is very, very important. So with regards to the fasting, zakat, likewise, zakatul fitr and Eid and many other rulings. So this is one of the basic preparations for the month of Ramadan. Secondly, my dear brothers in Islam, as we all know, that the month of Ramadan is the month of Quran. For us, generally, whenever we mention the word Ramadan, the very first thing that comes to our mind is fasting. No doubt, the month of Ramadan is the month of fasting, which is the pillar of Islam. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran made the mention of the word Ramadan only once. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the word Ramadan in the Quran, He did not say the month of Ramadan is the month in which the fasting is an obligation. Rather, Allah said, Shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran. The month of Ramadan is the month in which Quran was revealed. We need to ask ourselves, what type of relationship we have with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If you cannot enhance your relationship with the book of Allah, Dhul Jalal Ikram, within the month of Ramadan, then it may be difficult for you to establish that relationship with the Quran after the month of Ramadan. So this is the best time, best opportunity, best chance to strengthen your relationship and enhance your relationship with the book of Allah, Dhul Jalal Ikram. In terms of reciting the Quran, listening to the Quran, attending Salatul Taraweeh in order to listen the Quran, and also reflecting and pondering on the ayat of the Quran, going through the meaning and the tafsir of the Quran. It is also very, very important. And lastly, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, when it comes to the preparation for the month of Ramadan, the preparation does not include only with regards to the fasting and zakah and attending the masjid for Salatul Taraweeh. We must prepare ourselves mentally and spiritually, which means that from now, although we are very close already to the month of Ramadan, now we need to prepare ourselves mentally, and we must try our best now to change our daily habit and our daily routine. If you do not change yourself now, before the month of Ramadan starts, then you may end up losing the whole month of Ramadan in planning. The month of Ramadan begins, and you say, from tomorrow, I will do this, this, this. And then you miss the first day, you say, okay, from tomorrow, then next day, and day after, and next week, after weekend. Like this, the whole month of Ramadan goes, and you are fast approaching the end of the month of Ramadan, and now you regret. And this all because of not being mentally and spiritually ready before the month of Ramadan starts. That is why it is very important that we prepare ourselves now before the month of Ramadan starts. Whatever plan you want to make, make it now and finalize it now. In terms of your daily routine, in terms of your sleeping pattern within the month of Ramadan, you attending the masjid, attending for Salatul Taraweeh, and your work routine, everything, make the plan and finalize everything before the month of Ramadan begin, so that when the month of Ramadan starts, you are fully ready, and then you can spend the month of Ramadan smoothly, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He, Dhul Jalal Ikram, gives us tawfiq and ability to benefit from this blessed opportunity, the blessed month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq and ability. Innahu sami'un qaribun mujib. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. My dear brothers in Islam, I believe the community of Birmingham and the congregation of Green Lane, you are so blessed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the opportunity to seek knowledge, and through this masjid, Alhamdulillah, we offer so many opportunities of seeking knowledge. As I said, it is very important to learn about the fasting, the zakah, and everything related to the month of Ramadan. We have already delivered a 6 weeks intensive course covering various topics within the fiqh of fasting and zakat. And we have arranged another one for tomorrow and day after tomorrow, intensive course, fiqh of fasting. And then throughout the month of Ramadan, we will have so many activities taking place, all for you to take benefit. Throughout the month of Ramadan, we'll have daily tafsir of the Quran class that will be conducted by our respected brother, Dr. Ahsan Hanif, Hafidhahullah. And there will be other lectures and activities So we'd like to encourage every one of you to please take part in these activities and take the benefit and do not lose this opportunity. Wallahi, people around the country and even around the globe, not every single masjid offers these type of activities, and not the congregation of every single masjid has the opportunity to seek knowledge and to benefit from these activities. So that is why I say you are so blessed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you this opportunity. So you must make the best usage of this opportunity and do not miss it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He dhul jalal al-ikram gives us tawfiq and ability to increase our iman and to increase our knowledge. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He dhul jalal al-ikram allows us to witness the month of Ramadan and to observe the fasting of the month of Ramadan and to fulfill our obligations to Allah dhul jalal al-ikram within the month of Ramadan. And we also ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He dhul jalal al-ikram increases the love for the Quran in our hearts. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He dhul jalal al-ikram forgives our sins, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showers His mercy upon us. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala al-nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad. كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم أذهب البأس رب الناس واشف أنت الشافي لا شفاء إلا شفاؤك شفاء لا يغادر سقما. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم اغفر لنا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق وأعمالنا من الرياء وألسنتنا من الكذب وأعيننا من الخيانة، فإنك تعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها، أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم ألهمنا رشدنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم إنا نسألك الصحة والعفة والأمانة وحسن الأخلاق. اللهم اهدنا لأحسن الأخلاق لا يهدي لأحسنها إلا أنت، واصرف عنا سيئها لا يصرف عنا سيئها إلا أنت. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصل اللهم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.